Hello guys, so today I will discuss about the decision tree model. So what is decision tree and how to fit this model in R? Let's import these two libraries. So first is mass, and I'm using this library for importing the data set. This is birth WP, which is stored in this package, which is available in this package, and R part is the library which is being used for fitting the decision tree model in R. So library is the function for importing these two, for importing any package in R. So library mass and library R part. So like this, you have to select this and then control enter. You will see in the console that these are now run. Now you have to set the seed so that when you run the decision tree next time, you get the same predictions made by the this model. So set dot seed is a function, and that is actually using the same random numbers while it is sampling or it is running any kind of decision tree model. So you are taking any number inside 1 2 3 or 4 5 6, anything. So you have to do like the set dot seed 1 2 3. Now let's store this data frame birth WT in the data frame. Data frame is this syntax is for storing, for equal assigning. So birth WT is being assigned in this data frame, and we can see on the right hand side in this environment, global environment, that data frame, it has the number of observations which are in this data set is 189 observations, and the number of columns are 10. Let's have a look on this by clicking on this data frame, and on the left hand side we see that this is the data set. So these are the columns, and column names are given in the first row, that is low, age, LWP, race, and these are the column names. These are the index number of the rows, 85, 86, these are index, right? So let's try to understand what's the meaning of these variables. You have to read the manual of this data, and also if you see on this data set, you see that the low variable has only value 0 or 1. Maybe if you go scroll down, you will see that it has 0 and 1 values. So it is a binary value, so it will not, it is not a continuous variable, it is a categorical variable. So you need to, in R, you need to convert categorical variables properly for this model, R part model. You have to, for decision tree model, this R part function, you have to convert them as factor. So categorical will be converted into factor, so that decision tree model knows that you are treating them as categorical variable. If you don't tell the decision tree model that this is a categorical variable, then it will treat it as an integer, because these all are coded as integer values. If had it been character values, you have to convert them into factor again using the function as dot factor. Age is obviously a continuous variable. LWT is also seen. You can see that this is also continuous and this is also continuous. So you need to keep in mind that if it is a character variable, you need to convert into factor using as dot factor. If it is, if some of the variables are coded as integer and you know that these are categorical variables, then you need to again convert them into as dot factor. Otherwise, it will, the model does not have any meaning, because it will be treating wrong variables, some of the variables wrongly. In numerical variables will be categorical variables will be treated as numeric variables. Let's go on the script now again, and let's read the thing what is written in the birth WT by using the function help. So here you see, it is telling the risk factors associated with a low infant birth weight. So it is actually describing data frame low Low is the column and it is describing the weight of the child during the birth if it is less than 2.5 or not on the basis of the mother's parameters. So you are trying to predict whether the birth weight will be less than 2.5 or not based on the parameters associated with the mother's age, weight, height and other things. So you can see that what are the parameters are there which are related to mothers and all, whether the woman was smoking or not, race was white, black or other. You can see here white is coded as 1, black 2 and other 3. So these are just coded as integer, but these are categorical variables. So you need to convert them into absolute factor, into factor variables. So that is very important thing you need to keep in mind. Let's have a look on the structure of the data frame. You can see right now these categorical variables are coded as integer, but you need to convert them into factor. Low is also coded as integer. So low is the target variable, right? So again, you can use the dimension. You can check the dimension of the data, 189 observations and 10 columns. You can check the first three rows by using the function head. Head and data frame and comma 3, or you can write 5, 6 and anything. You can check the unique values by using this function. You can see that only 1.1% of 189 observations is unique. That is 1.1% of 189 will be 2, but only 2 unique values. So it is a binary variable. Like these all are very low percentages. So low percentage of unique values, these are categorical variable. Also you can read in the manual whether it makes sense or not to treat them as categorical. So you need to understand the meaning of the variables before you go ahead. So age, LWT and BWT is obviously a numerical variables because it has high unique values. So if there are 189 observations and 70% are unique in BWT, that, and you can also see the values in the data frame in BWT, these are the values. So you need to understand whether it makes sense or not, and what is BWT, birth weight in grams. So it is obviously a numerical variable. So let's store the categorical variables low, race, smoke, PTL, HT in quals. You can see it is stored in as a character vector. Then convert them into factors, sorry, for I in cons data frame as dot factor, then data frame I. So I is these columns iterated I in cons. Now let's have a look on the structure again. Now you can see that low is a factor variable which with 2 unique values, raise 3 values, white, black, other, smoke, yes or no, like this. These are unique values. So these are categorical data and these are numerical data, age, LWT and BWT. Now let's divide the data set into the testing data and the train data so that you can check it out how your model is performing on the unknown data. So we will fit the model on the training data set and then we will predict for the test data set using this decision tree model in R. So library CA tools is used for this function sample dot split, which is stored in this CA tools package, and we are dividing this data set based on this low variable and the split ratio is 0.8. so 80% of the data will be going to train data frame and rest will be going in test data frame. Again, you see in the test test data frame we have 38 observations and in train data frame so now we had we got the train data frame and the test data frame. So indices is if you see the indices, these are true false values. So train data frame and indices. So where we have the true, it will take all those observations in the train data frame.